There we go. That's someone who likes to play a cowbell. Four rings. I think everyone else has just done it once. There we go. How you doing?
Good. A little bit tired. The weather's like taking its toll, I think, but yeah, super hot. I'm just excited to be here, man. It's cool.
Yeah, fantastic. Yeah. We should say this. It's Liam from Casey. How you doing? So you played Avalanche stage later on. No, earlier on, wasn't it?
Yeah.
How was it?
Anyway, it was cool. We went in with kind of no expectation. Like, we don't really play festivals very often. It was full. People singing back, people shouting, a couple of stage diving. So.
Which is amazing after, what, a four-year break for the band?
Yeah. So we did our last show in 2018, came back at the start of this year, did a few shows, and this is the only show we've done since. So, yeah, straight back into the busy festival season. So,
yeah.
It's cool, man.
What was behind the breakup, or the hiatus, whatever you want to call it?
Yeah, we've all got quite busy personal lives. So, I've got two kids. Ojama Max has got two kids. We all kind of work jobs as well. So we were doing KC for so long that we just figured that we'd kind of pursue the other side of life.
Okay.
Try and see how that goes. And then we quickly, realized that kind of sucks. So yeah, we wanted to come back and
That can be a real killer for some bands, but you've come back to sold out shows, great reception.
Yeah, we're super lucky, man. Like, as I said, we came in with very low expectations. I think that's the best way to be, to think about anything, whereas you come in thinking, if we play to 50 people, I'll be stoked. Play to 100, that's great. And we ended up playing to a full tent, so, yeah, class.
Yeah, amazing, yeah.
So good.
Why now to come back?
We were kind of writing all the way through lockdown. I know the lockdown affected musicians in exactly the same way it did us. But me and Toby kind of continued writing.
Okay.
Even though we had nothing to really write for, we were always really writing for Casey,
right,
if that makes sense.
Yeah.
And then, when we had a couple of finished tracks, we kind of hit up Tom and we just figured we were all in a really good place, like, in our lives. And, like, we figured we could make this work around other things, but in our own terms. So when we discussed that, we were like, let's just do it.
Yeah,
so,
the timing just fell right.
100%, man. Yeah.
Awesome. How did it feel getting back into the room with all? Had you kind of been together in that 4 years at all?
Not at all.
No. So how was that?
So, yeah, like, we all kind of moved in different areas of South Wales.
Wow.
So, yeah, getting back in that room for the first time was really...
Yeah. Was it like there straight away?
Yeah.
Well, yeah. But the chemistry and the passion. Yeah. Brilliant. So what's the new material like? When can we expect it to come out? Spill the beans.
We don't have a release date, but it's definitely going to be next year. Preferably early-ish next year. It's very different. But it's still Casey, kind of big open choruses, all those kind of big guitar lines that people would expect. But we went with a different mindset. Like, if it sounds different but it's cool, then we're gonna make the record.
Yeah.
We didn't want to just be conventional Casey for another album. So yeah, it's quite experimental. It's really different, but fingers crossed people like it, man.
It's always like an interesting time coming back from a big break like that, because fans are going to expect a certain thing from the last record, but you guys have grown as people, as musicians, as artists. You want to create something different. So did you worry about that, like the fans' expectation at all?
Stuff.
And we know we've got to appease to
that somewhat, so there are parts on that record that are really, identifiable as Casey.
Yeah.
But then I think if nobody heard us, then there's parts on that record
for those guys as well,
okay.
So it definitely appeals to a wider audience, but it's gonna make the old school fans happy as well.
Yeah. Oh, fantastic. I think we've got a bit of a dodgy connection on that microphone.
Okay.
I think that's what it is. If you try to keep your hand up, it should hopefully be okay.
Yeah.
So what's next after Download? Have you got shows plugged in?
Yeah. We're doing, I always fail to pronounce this,
Jera
on Earth in Belgium with some cool bands. Then we're doing 2000 Trees. And then we go to the US for 3 weeks. So we're doing a headline tour out there. And then we just focus on the release of the album, man. And then there'll be some headline shows around the release. So, and we'll do all the mainland Europe, all the UK. Slowly trickle back into those kind of bigger shows, hopefully. So
that'd be really cool to ease your way back into it, I guess. Yeah. I'm looking forward to 2000 Trees. I'm going for the first time this year. I've not been before.
Same, man. I've never been before. So I'm going to take my kids because it's like a family-friendly kind of thing. So,
I
bet the kids are going to love it, aren't they?
Yeah. So my son's, he's 6, and he's like a really big kind of like rock / like metal fan. So. Yeah, man, it'd be cool to get him up on stage, hopefully.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah.
Is he learning any instruments or anything?
He is. He He's learning drums, which out of all the instruments, you know,
I kind of... My son learns drums as
well. So every band needs a drummer. So I was like, you should definitely do that. Yeah. You know, not every band needs a guitarist and a bass player. So he's going to be a drummer for sure. Yeah.
Which I took that approach with my son with both music and sport.
Nice.
He's a goalkeeper as well. So like, everyone needs a drummer. Every football team needs a goalkeeper.
Nice.
What kind of bands are they looking forward to seeing then when you take them to festivals like
2003? From my son's perspective.
Yeah, your son, yeah, what the hell are you looking forward to?
Well, like, he really likes us, obviously, which is cool. I play loads of, like, American football in the house. That's, like, one of my favourite bands. So he'll be listening to those as well. He's going to have to just watch what I watch. Really, he hasn't really got a choice.
Who are you looking forward to, then?
Definitely American football. Yeah. I want to see Loathe as well. We know those guys. That'll be really cool. Mainly those two, I think. Yeah.
Are you catching anyone here this weekend?
We're going to watch Coheed. So
nice.
They're headlining our stage. I've never seen them before, but I'm stoked to watch them.
Yeah.
I would have liked to watch Alexis, but we're here and I've not had any food yet. But Coheed mainly, man.
Yeah, fantastic. Well, I'll let you get to it. Thanks for taking the time to talk to me.
Thank you so much. Cheers, bro.
Cheers.
Thank you.